Here is the candidate for today's video. It is a Marvel Schebler DLTX model 67 carburetor. If you can see that on the machined into that little boss right there. It's hard to see. There it is. But I'm going to go through and I'm going to pull out these plugs real quick, and then I'm going to show you kind of where all of the fuel flows through this carburetor so that you can understand exactly what's going on when you rebuild this carburetor. I've done this in other videos, but they've been longer videos going through the entire carburetor. This one, I'm just going to do a real quick video so that then it might be a little bit easier for people to watch. My goal is to be about 8 minutes long. So first, I'm going to go through and I'm going to pull out all of these brass plugs, and then we can start going through and looking at what needs to be done. I'm also going to pull out. Okay, I've got all of these brass plugs pulled out right there, there. The two here at the end, and then I also got the two needle valves pulled out for the load and the idle adjust. So I'm telling you, if you just hit them with a little bit of heat from a torch, just like this one, then man, they come right out. It's amazing how they won't budge, and then you just hit them with a little bit of heat, and then all of those little plugs, they just come right out. And then I got all, besides that, I got everything else pulled out. You can see down in here, this has been sitting on a shelf, I can tell, for a long time. It's full of, there's some wasp nests and stuff down in there. But now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pull that emulsion tube out. In the other video that I showed you how to take that emulsion tube out, I used a couple of bolts and some nuts, and I pulled it out kind of like you would with a flywheel puller. But another tool that works really well is just a slide hammer like this. So I've just taken a screw that has pretty coarse threads like this, and I've screwed it down in and let the first few threads of this bite down into that emulsion tube. It's brass, I mean, it's soft. And then I'm just gonna give this a quick, using the slide hammer, a quick pull upwards, and then we'll see if it comes out. It might work, it might not, it might just come loose, we'll see. There it goes. I thought I'd show you real quick, this emulsion tube, it's actually not that dirty. I mean, you can see most of those holes are actually still open. I'm still gonna clean them out. But all of this, these seeds and dead bugs and rust and dirt that just poured out of the top of this, out of this stem as I turned it upside down. And so really, you just always got to pull that emulsion tube out and make sure that it's in good shape. I'm first going to talk to you about the load side of your carburetor. You have your load adjust needle right here. As you screw this in and out, what it's doing is the bottom of that needle is a tapered point, and it's screwing down into this tapered hole. And you think about this carburetor, you have your float bowl here, your fuel bowl, and it's completely enclosed. And the only way for fuel to get here, you know, out on the outside of this this stem where the emulsion tube sits, to the inside of the stem where the emulsion tube is, and get sucked up into the carburetor through this emulsion tube, is to go through this hole right there. And so if you screw this load needle all the way down in, what you're doing essentially is closing off and not letting any fuel get down into the inside of this stem. As you screw it out, you're obviously letting more fuel in. So we've got to make sure that this hole right here that passes from out here on the outside of the stem to the inside of the stem down inside there is clean. So I'm going to clear that out right now. I've got this piece of MIG welder wire right here. It's probably about 30 thousandths in diameter. Sticking it down inside here. I'm just gonna make sure, oh yeah, make sure that it passes. Can you see down in there? Make sure that it passes into the inside of this tube nice and easily. Flipping the Carburetor over, we're now looking at the idle adjust or the idle circuit side of the carburetor. If this is mounted on the tractor, this is what's out facing towards you. And similar to the load adjust side, we've got a needle adjust valve right here. The thing is the needle comes down in and you can see there's a hole right here in the side of the stem. And what we're doing is when we adjust this needle in and out, we're regulating the amount of fuel that goes through this hole. Now, for the idle side, we're bypassing the emulsion tube and the main, what you would call like the main jet of your carburetor. You're bypassing that and you're going, the idle fuel is going through that hole into a small little chamber that's right here. I took this brass plug out so that we can make sure that that chamber is clear. Now, fuel will go through that hole into this chamber. Then there's another passageway that goes up the side of the stem right here, drilled through this brass plug that's next to the idle adjust needle. Now, there's another hole right here, passageway that goes through the carburetor, or through the end of the carburetor, through this hole. I took that screw out and it goes back and it connects to this. And this, if you look down inside your carburetor here, you've got three little holes, one, two, three, in the lower one, and that is where the fuel for your idle is allowed to enter the engine out here by your throttle butterfly valve. And so now we're going to go through and make sure that all of those passageways are clear from this hole into the chamber up the side of this stem and then out this tube, this passageway, and into those three little holes right there on the inside barrel of your carburetor. So to check all of those, I'm just going to do the same thing I did last time using this piece of MIG welder wire. Basically just going to make sure that I can stick this down in. Maybe it'll be easier to go up through here. Yep, make sure that I've got clearance there. And make sure that there's not any junk down in here. And I can see in here there is a little bit of junk. But it looks like it's kind of loose. Then the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stick this wire down through here. Oh, and you can see that it passes easily down into, passes easily down into this chamber. Then we'll pass this wire down through here. Make sure. Oh yeah, there it is. Make sure that we can see the wire down inside there. Let me turn on my light. Maybe you can see it. Can you see my wire down in there? So now we know that this passageway is open. And, oh, there's a little bit of junk that came out of there. And now we know that fuel is able to get from the stem through all of these passageways out to these two holes down here. This wire won't fit in that passageway, but I will just squirt some WD-40. I'll just squirt some WD-40 in here and make sure that we have WD-40 that comes through those two holes. Yep, there's those two right there. And then the third hole is in this other tube, which I will explain now. So, the other portion of the idle circuit is, if we look through here, through the choke end of your carburetor, we've got a hole. There's two holes down inside of your carburetor, one right here and one down in the bottom. This base one, we'll have to make sure it's clean. It actually goes down into the chamber where the emulsion tube is. This other one right here, oh, there's also a hole right here. It's clogged on this one. But this hole and that hole on the inside, they go into these two portions of your carburetor, these two areas of your carburetor, down into where the needle adjust is. And then there's also another brass plug that goes right here. And I can see that there's some junk down inside there. I'll clean that out. But this, I'm not positive here. I'm not an expert on this, but I believe that this is basically kind of like a vent that allows the fuel to escape out of the fuel out of the bowl out freely into the engine without causing any suction inside of here. So we have to have make sure that we have good ventil th this vent these vent holes and these vent lines are clear so that then there's not like an internal suction that's keeping fuel down. We want everything to flow nice and smoothly. So I'm now going to clean out these passageways for these vents, what I'm calling them vents, and make sure that they're clean. So here we are back with our MIG welder wire. We're going to go in through this hole right here. This is on the choke side of the carburetor, the inlet of your carburetor. Just make sure that we can see that wire passing nice and easily into this hole right here where your idle adjust needle valve goes. Your other one right here, which is all clogged. This is all clogged with a bug nest, I can tell. And I can see more bug nest down in here. You can hear it. So we've really got to clear that out. I'm just going to break it up with this needle, mash it up, and then we'll use some compressed air and some WD-40 to kind of clear all that out. Then going in from this other side, we'll go in here through this hole, the lower hole. Oh man, I can feel there's some bug nest in this too. There it goes. That's all. This was clogged with some bugs. But you can see now, down inside this hole, you can see the needles finally made it. So I've ramrodded that passageway clean. Now we'll just take some time with some WD-40 and some compressed air, make sure that that is completely clear and free. And then we have all of the idle passageways cleaned out on this carburetor. You gotta see this. So as like I mentioned, this one vent hole, this is really clogged, and you can see it's just as I am ramrodding this wire in here, you can just see how much junk is falling out of that hole. This is obvious that this was way clogged. You can just see some bug parts, some bug nest parts coming out of this. So yeah, that was very dirty. One other thing I failed to mention is this is a vent right here that also connects. This is the vent hole that going to goes into the carburetor here, into the fuel bowl, and it connects up. You can see there's on some, this is a different style of carburetor. Sometimes this is a like a permanently filled plug right here, where they drilled from here down in and connected to this passageway. But this, so like I say, this passage from here up into this vent that we were just cleaning out, we need to make sure that that's clear also. Switching gears from the body of the carburetor, now we've got to just make sure that the emulsion tube is clear through the middle of the emulsion tube, and then also each one of these holes up and down the length of the emulsion tube is clear and clean. So, using my trusty MIG welder wire again, I'm just gonna ramrod that through here. It was clogged. There's a bug nest down in there. Okay. Pieces of bug nest coming out of there. Then, using the same, this 30,000s, I think it's 30,000s MIG welder wire, actually fits through every single one of these holes in the emulsion tube perfectly. So, and every single one of these has been clogged. It actually looked clean, but the bug nest built that, well, that one wasn't clogged. And then this top one, it was good too. Okay. Okay, with that clean, I will just spray some carb cleaner through all of this. Make sure that we have carburetor cleaner coming through all of these holes when I close it off. And then that's all of the fuel passages in this carburetor and then the emulsion tube. We can reassemble it and make sure that we have good fuel flow from the fuel bowl down in here, all the way up into all parts of the carburetor and into the engine. Lastly, you just want to make sure, after you get your emulsion tube right here all clean and nice, you want to make sure that the stem of your carburetor is nice and clean. I do that just by taking one of these wire kind of round brushes from Harbor Freight, just shoving it down in there, and pulling it in and out, and let's see if I can get the inside of that all nice and clean. Now, it is ready to reassemble. Okay, I've got the bowl put back together, I've got the floats put in there, float set, everything's put back together. I've got the choke on this side, I've got the throttle on this side, everything's moving nice and freely. Now, this carburetor should be ready to go put back onto the tractor. So, hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, please like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks so much.